We're asked to apply the distributive property to factor out the greatest common factor. And we have 35 plus 50 is equal to, so let me get my scratch pad out. So we have 35 plus 50 is equal to, now what's the greatest common factor of 35 and 50? So what's the largest whole number that's divisible into both of these? Well, I could write 35 as, let's see, I could write that as 5 times 7. And I could write 50 as 5 times 10. And so we see 5 is the greatest common factor. 7 and 10 don't have any factors in common. So I could rewrite this. I could write 35 as equal to 5 times 7. And I could rewrite 50 as equal to, get another color here. I could rewrite 50 as 5 times 10. 5 times 10, and of course I'm adding them. So I have plus right over here. If I want, I could put parentheses, but order of operations would make me do the multiplication first anyway. But now I want to factor out that greatest common factor. I want to factor out the 5. So what I'm really doing right over here is I am unwinding the distributive property. So if I factor out a 5, this is going to be equal to, let's factor out the 5, 5 times. So you do 35 divided by 5, you're just left with the 7. You're just left with the 7 over here. So you're just left with the 7 after you factored out the 5. And over here, you're just left with the 10. So 5, or 7, plus 7 plus 10. And we're done. 35 plus 50 is equal to 5 times 7 plus 10. So let me now go and type that in. So this is the same thing as 5 times 7 plus 10. And you know you factored out the greatest common factor because 7 and 10 don't have any factors in common anymore. That they're called relatively prime. They have no factors in common other than 1. So we could now check that. Let's do a couple more of these. Apply the distributive property to factor out the greatest common factor. So let's see if we can just do this one a little bit faster. So let's see, the largest number is divisible in both 75 and 20. Well, I don't know, let me try 5. So if I say 5 times, so 75 divided by 5, let's see, is going to be 15. Is that right? Yeah, because 5 times 10 is 50. 5 times 5 is 25. Yeah, so it's 15. And I got that 15 by dividing 75 by 5. So 15 plus, and then 20 divided by 5 would be 4. 15 plus 4. And let's see, did I do this right? 15 and 4 don't have any factors in common. And if I were to apply the distributive property here, I'd have 5 times 15 is 75. 5 times 4 is 20. Yeah, I'm feeling good about that. Got it right.